Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. We are back and we are doing Toy Story nails because we all love Toy Story. I mean, four they've done now. I think it's going to be like Too Fast and Furious. It's going to be like Fast and Furious again. I've like seven, aren't they?
There's about 500 of those, isn't there?
There's so many, aren't there? Yeah. But yeah, we really love it. So we're going to do Buzz Lightyear in this video on this nail. We have the fabulous Kate in today.
Kitty.
So, and she's loving the fact that we're doing Toy Story nails on her, aren't you?
Yeah.
We're going to do a ballerina shaped nail on the entire set. And we're just doing some individual videos so you can see how much detail goes into creating them and hopefully learn a lot along the way. Now prep dehydrator, and then we're going to use the ultra bronze
2 hours later
ultra bond acid primer. So sculpting this out in natural beige. Oh, that did not want to come off because it was a little bit dry, but I know my brush is wet, so I know it's going to hydrate it again. So that's a good way of just judging what you can do. If you put that bead on and you think, oh, it's a little bit dry, you can touch it with your brush and it will force more of the liquid back into that bead.
Oh, look at that, sorry.
Oh, look at that, we're nearly at the end of the form. And we told you were having, what, a 1.5? Just a 1.5, but we need a little bit of filing room. Next bead at the cuticle area, tipping the finger down so it doesn't flood into that cuticle. You don't want the product to touch the cuticle. Sweep it out if it does, but you want to keep everything nice and clean. Right, so I'm going to wait for this to go matte and then I'll test pinch it. As I feel this with my dodgy finger.
You say, is that a cut?
No, this is paint from a previous video.
Oh, you mean the dodgy?
My dodgy with a quarter missing. I can feel that this is setting. This is still a little bit rubbery, but I want to test pinch this area here because that is where the pinching tool will sit. So I'm test pinching with my fingers to feel if it's got a bit of bounce in it still. By Kate's face, it still has a bit of bounce.
I literally just saw it right. Through our nostrils up to our brain. I thought we were not going to do that to people anymore.
I was just testing it.
She's a bit softer.
I'll get my revenge
at
the weekend with a homebrew.
So I'm going to pop that pinching tool on now and then I'm going to check that it's not collapsing, and it's not, so I can just leave that on there and let it pinch. Right, so I'm just going to pinch down the length and then we're going to take off the foam and we're going to file. I'm going to do my normal filing routine, which is sidewalls first. Got a 180 grit file.
What's the reason you do the sidewalls first off?
Because I like to see that everything's coming out straight and then I can work from there. It's a good point to work from. And then from that sidewall, we then start to do the cuticle. So it all starts to connect. So remove any bulk from around that cuticle, get it nice and flush. You don't want a big lip at the back here. Then I'm going to do the free edge. So we're working round. And then I'm going to come up the sides to reduce any bulk. And then I can contour that top section. Just going to buff it to make it a little bit smoother. Dust off.
Why are you using a harder nail brush instead of just like a lot of puffy ones normally?
Because I'm finding that that really does get the dust out a lot better. Gets into those little
nooks and crannies. Yeah. Nooks yeah. and
crannies. Right, so now we're going to put a base on for our Buzz Lightyear design. So I've got some Snow White and then I've got some Firecracker. Oh. might have missed the bottle a little bit. What I'm going to do is do some blocks of white lines, and this is just taking inspiration from Buzz Lightyear's wings. So when he does, you know, the classic to infinity and beyond, and we don't need to pull these all the way across because this part will be covered. Just cure that for me. Then with the red, we're going to come in between. Do you remember when everybody wanted Buzz Lightyear for Christmas?
Mm-hmm. You couldn't get them anywhere.
No. Think I'll get away with doing one coat of this red. Pop me that in the lamp. Then I've got glass and a half. And I'm going to do two coats of that just in this section here. Pop that in. So you won't see a lot of this, but that is fine. But we need something in the background. I am going to use Beauty Beneath for Buzz's face. We will mix a little bit of white into that as well and do some different shades. So if I grab a bit of that and a bit of white. Right, so I'm going to apply this thin because I'm just going to get this shape of Buzz's big fat head. I feel like he has a big fat head.
It's a chiselled jaw is what it is.
Is that what it is? Chiselled. A chiselled jaw. A chiselled superhero jaw.
Yeah, he's got like a chiselled jaw. Big muscly like chest, hasn't he?
Mm-hmm.
A tiny waist, like he's got some kind of like
proper triangle. Pop me that in. So I've put two coats of that colour on. Now I'm just using Beauty Beneath as it comes out of the bottle, which adds a little bit of shading. We're going to come around here and go right to the bottom of his chin. His big old chin. Start to add where his cheeks will be and his nose. The space from his mouth to the bottom of his chin is actually the same as from the top of his mouth to the top. That's how big, I thought I'd got a big chin. Has everybody just said, yeah, you have got a big chin?
No.
I think all the viewers have gone, oh, yeah, I've got a bit of a big chin. Guess not as big as Buzz Lightyear.
Just.
Only just. Right, pop me that in. So I'm going to use Cashmere. Just go round his eyes and it'll just create a little shadow. So we don't need to like outline them with black or anything like that. The Cashmere colour is enough. Pop that in. So it's time for eyebrows and we've got one raised eyebrow. I can't raise either of mine.
Why is that, Kirsty?
What? There's a reason I can't raise either of my eyebrows. But I couldn't raise one either before. Can you raise one? Oh, how do you do that? Can you do it?
No, it's like a bit spacious. I don't want to do that. I think I need mine tattooed on. Because I was a 90s plucker.
A 90s plucker?
Mm. Isn't that weird when you pluck your eyebrows and they're just like tiny things? And then you put some toner on once, Kirsty.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to the restaurant when I was meeting my boyfriend and he went, fucking hell, you look really angry. And he proceeded to call me Angry Brows for the next 2 years.
You like that?
Oh, that's not very nice.
I did look angry. They were black, though. You did them black. It was just not good.
They weren't that dark.
Where?
They were just darker than what you were used to.
They're also triple the size of what I was used to, no?
They look funny. Good.
It was like that, honestly, it was like Buzz, that was... That's what you did to me, Kirk.
I did
Buzz
not.
Like look like Buzz Lightyear.
I did not make you look like Buzz Lightyear. Put them in the lamp and shut up. I'm bloody good at brows, thank you very much. Right, we're going to take a little bit of Cashmere and a little bit of black. Just darken that a little bit. Because we're going to do that random swirl on his chin. Is it like a random hair? It's supposed to be like a random hair.
I don't know.
Is it not like one of those dimples? What's that?
Yeah, it's a swirl. I mean, it's like a swirl.
A bum chin.
Yeah.
But it's a swirl.
Well, bum hole's already rid of a swirl.
Put that in the lamp. Right. So, and we also need to do a mouth as well. And I think we're going to use this colour that we've just mixed to... put his mouth in and we sort of go from cheek to cheek for his mouth. We have a little bit of a dimply bit there. Pop it in the lamp. Now he is a bit buzz-eyed there. Is he supposed to be a bit buzz-eyed?
I don't think so.
Because on that picture, he is defo a little bit buzz-eyed. Isn't he?
Yes.
Maybe that adds a bit of character because he is a toy and he's not real and, you know. I'm going to use Azure for his iris colour of his eyes. So,
it's like they'd come alive at night and start talking to each other.
Yeah.
That'd be a bit freaky, wouldn't it?
Oh, God. I'm now going to have like a dream about that or a nightmare or something now. I'll wake up like and my hands will just be by my pillow and I'll be like,
it's looking at me.
Pop me that in the lamp. So a tiny dot of the black, and I even did that while the blue was wet, so it's not going to move around. You can cure the blue and then do the black if you didn't feel comfortable doing that. So let's get this purple and do his slight little outfit.
His space suit.
Space suit.
His little outfit. He'd be so offended.
He would, wouldn't he?
He would. He's very easily offended, Buzz is.
Space Ranger.
Thank you for putting that song in my head.
What's that? One?
Stop the pigeon, stop the pigeon.
Used to live for Sunday mornings, used to live for that.
Hey, you need to come have a go in the body composition scan. I've got a body comp scanner.
I do need to do that. Pop that in the lamp. Right, so we need a little bit of white mixed in with a glass and a half to make it lighter. And then we can add some little highlights. pop that in the lamp. You're going to use a little bit of grey and a little bit of green, and then it is nearly done. So the grey is called Soft Grey, and the green is Toxic Waste.
I'm so excited that he's on my nail.
Pop this in.
Proper fan.
So just a line of that grey and that green is enough to give you the impression of his space outfit. Pop it in the lamp. So I'm going to top coat this. Just going to seal the gel polish. And I'm going to do two top coats just to smooth that surface. Pop that in. I'm just going to buff this lightly, which will help smooth as well. I'm going to top coat. Pop it in the lamp. So take the matte top coat, pop it onto the backing paper of the sculpting form, and what I'm going to do is just go over his face and make his face matte. So I'm just going to take a dotting tool, go around the outside first, his face. Pop me that in the lamp. So we're going to wipe over to remove the sticky layer. And he now has a matte face. That looks cool. Right, let me put some cuticle oil on now to finish off. If you want to see this complete set, make sure you watch the part 3 of the Toy Story episode. We should do 4 really, because there's 4. There's like the 4th one.
Just have one plain one.
Yeah. We should have 4 parts to it, shouldn't we really, but there's only 3. Oh well. So don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll see you in the next video, guys. Keep watching. Bye bye. There's one for your video, right?
Compilation.
Yeah. That looks cool. Love it. Love it.
My feet today, I just keep catching everything.
You're clumsy, man.